Hello, everyone. Welcome to this session. We're going to be talking about synchronizing data with .NET MAUI to make your mobile applications more resilient and more responsive to your users. And we're going to be doing that with Azure Mobile Apps. So what is Azure Mobile Apps? Azure Mobile Apps is a set of libraries on both a client and server side that allows you to build offline capable data-driven applications. That increases the resilience and responsiveness of your mobile UI because the data is local to the system. The resilience increases because you can do queries and do the display based on a local database. And it's responsive because of the same thing. The data is right there where you need it. In order to do this, you're going to integrate the Azure Mobile Apps library into your .NET MAUI application. And you're also going to create a backend service based on ASP.NET Core that hosts the data in the cloud. So let's talk about building the mobile backend. And this will really be the simplest way that you could create a basic CRUD API that you will ever see. To start with, we use a standard entity framework core setup. So that means you create a connection string to connect your database to your application. You'll use SQL Server or Cosmos DB or whatever else other drivers that you want. You then use this magic line which says add data sync controllers. Now we'll be producing a data sync controller in a moment, but this is the magic that makes it all work for you. You can see the basic program for your ASP.NET Core application is really, really small. It's a matter of a couple of dozen lines usually. Now the data model that you're going to be using needs a bit of augmentation. When you're dealing with synchronizing data from the back end to the front end, you're going to need some extra information. First of all, the IDs are not going to be numeric anymore. They're going to be globally unique IDs. And secondly, we need to know when the last time that the entity was updated and what the version of that entity was. So the entity table data here, which is an implementation of a table data of those three fields, is actually part of the model. You can then produce an API controller. And this one, I've got just a basic controller. It can go on any route, just like normal. It's just an API controller. But instead of saying API controller, you're going to say table controller. And finally, you're going to wire up the controller to a repository. Now, this is a standard repository pattern that the library provides for you. And this one happens to use entity framework core. And what this controller does for you is it gives you six specific routes. You get the basic CRUD, so create, replace, delete. You get the ability to update with a patch, and you can use the JSON patch or the more normal JSON merge patch. And you get the ability to get an item and list items. And the list items allows you to do basic filtering on any field, it allows you to select the fields that you want, and it allows you to do paging. The important thing to note here is this is just an ASP.NET Core web API. So if you want to use authentication authorization, you can do that. If you want to run it on your local machine, you can do that. If you want to run it in a container, great, go for it. We can use any database that Entity Framework Core supports, as long as the database supports millisecond accuracy when storing timestamps. And that's a star on that support. SQLite is a common request, and SQLite unfortunately doesn't meet these requirements. Azure Mobile Apps provides you with CRUDL, with OData filtering, authorization policies out of the box to limit data visibility, versioning, conflict resolution, and incremental offline sync. And those last two bullet points there are really important when we talk about offline synchronization with your mobile application. So let's talk about how to do offline sync with .NET MAUI. Normally, you will establish the SQLite store during that first page. So if you imagine you're starting a mobile application and there's usually a screen that is has a spinner on it and says, I'm initializing before it gets onto the main application. The work to do the offline cache and the initial synchronization is generally done within that page. It's all async, so you'll have to monitor for it. And it comes up with four steps. First of all, you're going to create a SQLite store. That SQLite store can live wherever it needs to on your application. I tend to use the MAUI Essentials to get the location of the application data store for that. You're then going to define the tables that you want to store in the offline store. Now, you don't have to define all of the tables. There is a remote table as well that you can use if some of the tables are good for offline and some you want to store remotely. That's good. That's good to do. You're then going to create a singleton client. Now, this client coordinates all of the requests to and from the service. And finally, you're going to initialize the database. Now, as your application evolves and you have more tables or more changes to the models, then the initialize offline store async makes sure that the offline store is up to date. Finally, you're going to get a reference to the offline table, which you can do as many times as you want. You can do it in single pages. It doesn't have to be a singleton, this guy. The client does have to be a singleton, but the table doesn't. Your next step is to synchronize the data from the cloud. There's two operations here. There's one, which is to push the items from the local offline cache to the remote server. And then there's a second operation that pulls the items that have changed from the remote server down to your offline cache. You can run this as many times as you want. It will just pull the changes that have been made and not the entire table. So if you've got, for example, 50,000 records for whatever reason, and only five of them have been changed, you're only going to pull down those five records. And then you can use the offline cache pretty much like you would use any other repository. So for example, you can get all of the items in the table. We use an async iterator to make it easy. So as the records are retrieved, they're available to you. You can use link. There's a selection like where, select, order by, and so on to allow you to do basic operations on the table. Use the to list async and the async operations for link to convert them into arrays or lists or whatever you need to use. And then you've got a set of operations to add, remove, and update items within the table. Now, when you call these, the item is updated insert it. So for example, if you don't specify an ID, then the item ID will be set for you. When the items are pushed up to the service, you'll want to pull them from the offline cache because they will be updated with the latest updated at and version. We do support a remarkably large number of platforms. So the single platform, we don't just support .NET MAUI, we support WinUI 3, the older Xamarin, the .NET MAUI Xamarin Forms. We also support some of the third-party frameworks like Avalonia and Uno. On the server platform, it's just a regular ASP.NET Core web API using Entity Framework Core. You can also create your own repository. So if you want to integrate third-party databases that Entity Framework Core does not support, you can write those relatively easily. The restrictions I mentioned are that millisecond timestamp requirement for the updated app timestamp. You can use any hosting platform. So we're not limited to just using app service, for example. You can use container apps, Kubernetes services. You can even run this on-premise. And you can use any authorization provider. So we provide examples, for example, with Azure AD, but there's nothing stopping you from integrating with Facebook, Google, Twitter, and so on. For more information, you can look at our documentation, which I've provided the link, aka.ms/AzureMobileApps/docs. We've got a wide variety of quick starts to get you started, go through the capabilities of creating an application, integrating the remote table, then integrating offline sync, and then integrating authentication into that application. We also have a lively community discussion board. So if you have problems, you run into issues, we've got lots of people that can help you. You can get that at aka.ms/AzureMobileApps/discuss. And we do operate in the open. This is an open source project. So you can check us out at github.com/Azure/AzureMobileApps. And with that, thank you very much for joining. Thank you for listening. And if you do have any questions, please do reach out.